Members of the Uganda Parliamentary Caucus expressed their disappointment in a press conference today over the inequitable allocation of parish development model funds. Of the 17 million shillings that was allocated to parishes recently, Buganda region walked away with only 170 billion for 1,071 parishes against a population of 12 million people. The caucus claims the amount is far below what other regions bagged.
939, one parish in Moroto. You have a parish in Chireka that has got 98,000 people. You are giving both of them the same amount of what? Money. That is not fair. So that's the point we are trying to make.
There are parishes with around 1,000 people, 500 people. You can't compare them. Either we have a program that goes down to villages, but equally our villages are still wider and bigger based on our population statistics. But as well, oh, there must be an increment if this program is to be purposeful for our people, especially in the central region.
The caucus chairperson, Muhammad Muwanga Chivumbi, has tasked government to consider democrating more parishes according to population data of Uganda Bureau of Statistics in the central region, or else allocate more funds to densely populated parishes in Buganda.
Give equal amount of money, all in the alternative, because parishes are easily created. Let's cut the average number of people per parish and we go and create parishes in accordance to the population. So that when you say 4,000, every 4,000 we create a parish. So that you give us 100 million. But otherwise, that's why Buganda with the biggest population density of 12 million out of 43 is going to receive 170 billion, while Eastern, with a population of 10, is going to receive the highest 332 billion.
Legislators representing constituencies in Buganda advised government to rectify the distribution mode of funds to avoid discrimination in the national development agenda.
Buganda region has a population of 12 million and 2.3 million households, but only 1,701 parishes, and therefore is going to access 170 billion. Northern region, which has less population than us, it has 8.63 million people with 1 million households and has 2,300 parishes, and therefore is going to be entitled to 230 billion, much more than what Buganda is going to get.
The parish model, but it is also very important that if we are to have the gains anticipated, then we must go through the right path. Going by example, Kofi under UCDA is 44 billion. And in Buganda, we are promoting Kofi under Emwanyi Terimba. Just in December 2021, Uganda, not Buganda, but Uganda earned $75 million in 1 month. So that earning is not for Buganda. But Buganda had a big, big contribution towards that $75 million. And therefore, we see an opportunity where actually the people who are going to participate in coffee growing are going to be losing seedlings, or they will not be able to get seedlings. And therefore, in one or the other, Uganda will be actually fighting the target of hitting 40 million bags by the year 2030.
Buganda caucus has equally protested government's plan to withdraw funds from the Luwero Renzori Ministry and Uganda Coffee Development Authority to fund the famous parish development model. The group says they can't stand to lose affirmative action plans tailored for Buganda region in favor of a program that is already disadvantaging their region.
When you come and take away money for coffee seedlings, Buganda is about coffee. It's the main export here. So you are giving us small money, disregarding population. You are taking away coffee. You are taking away Luwero Rwenzori. Extremely unfair.
In the same vein, the Buganda Parliamentary Caucus has hatched plans to save Parliamentary Commissioner Francis Zakei from being impeached from the job. Chivumbi explained that they cannot look on when the only commissioner from the central region is facing censure over unclear circumstances.
We believe the matters at hand are not insurmountable and should not boil down to majorities who wins. So we are going to seek a meeting with the speaker with a view to settle that issue.
Is it too late?
No, it's never too late to do things right. It's never too late to do a right thing. It's never too late for humanity to find dialogue. That's what makes us human.
Buganda Caucus decry inequitable allocation of parish model funds.